Hi, I'm Mick from Superior Engineering. Today in this episode we're going to show you how to fit a shaft of Amadaxtreme into the body and then how to bleed that shock properly. So this is a shaft. We just rebuilt the neck bush assembly in a previous video, and this is our wear band. So we've got our shock here. Now what we recommend here is actually removing the end cap out of the reservoir, because you've got to have some indication of where that floating piston is. So basically what they are inside here, there's a little circlip, so you've got to get that circlip out. Now most of the time they'll come out fairly easy. It's a matter of pushing that in, and then you'll see, if you can zoom in, you'll see there's a little circlip in here. So have a pick and just get that out. Just clip. Now it's not just going to fall out, because there's a groove in here and the O-ring has pulled onto that groove. We just got a very basic little tool we use here because we do shocks every day, and it just threads onto the Schroeder valve and we can pull that out. You can do that with, you can just go down to Super Cheap and buy your general little kit for air, like tyres and that, and they have like a little T-handle piece in there. You can use those. We just screw that on there, and then you just gradually work it out. If you just try and pull it straight, it's sometimes hard. If you just gentle left to right movements, it'll come out. If you've got a leak in this area here, that's the O-ring you want to change. So that would just be a matter of just seal pick that out, put your new O-ring on, a little bit of rubber grease, check there's no damage to that O-ring, and you put it back together. If you're only replacing that, and it's only just because it's got a leak, say you've got an air leak or something at the back, then you won't need to re-oil it or something. But that's only if you've got an air leak. If you've got oil coming out the back, well then your floating piston's got a damaged seal. But for this situation, basically, we've got that out now. You can see in there the floating piston. Floating piston is just a solid piece of aluminium in here that separates the oil from the gas. So what we want to do is make sure that's pushed all the way up. Now, hammer handle works well because it's timber, it's not going to scratch anything. Just make sure your oil level, you don't want to overflow while you're doing this, because as you push that down, if it's over full, it's going to spew out. All right, now that's hit. That piston has hit all the way back down to this fitting. So now what we're going to do is hang that down. If there's any air in that air line, that air is going to come up and out and then come up to the top. Now it's very simple. Basically, the amount of oil you want in there is about that level there. So I'll give you a bit of a measurement. Somewhere around the 30 millimeters from the very top is a starting point. That'll be pretty close to where we want to be at. All right, now we've got that, and there's no bubbles and that in there, because if you pour oil in, you might get a heap of bubbles and that. You want to let those bubbles come up, settle to the top before you go too much further. Wear band goes on, make sure that wear band fits nice. It's not jamming or anything like that. Just close up your wear band. Gently push that in. If you push in fast, you're probably going to get oil over you because of the bleed, so just go slow. As you can see, bubbles coming up. What we're trying to do here is bleed the bubbles out of underneath the piston. So you just got to go slow. If you push it down fast, it'll move the floating piston in the reservoir, which you don't want to do yet. So work that up and down. When you're happy there's no more bubbles, just pull it up far enough so it doesn't come out of the oil. I've got rubber grease on here to make it a lot easier. Work that down slowly. As you can see, oil is just starting to come around here. So at that point, probably put a rag around to keep it nice and clean. And this is where you want to push it down. What's going to happen now that O-rings hit here, from this point on, is going to move, it's going to seal, so it's going to push the oil and push that reservoir a little bit. Oh, sorry, the floating piston.
So push that in, like that.
Enough to get our circlip in. Circlip the same between the res and the main body. So make sure that circlip's in nice. Now what you can do here, you can push that shock down all the way just to be safe. Make sure you haven't mucked anything up. You're getting full compression. A little bit of rubber grease. Some that to make it easier. Push it nice and straight. Just pops in. Circlip. Make sure that circlip's in properly. Pull that back, you know it's in safe. Then put the Schroeder in. Check your Schroeder has no damage before you're putting it in. Nip it up nice and tight. Now you don't have to use a no-loss gauge just to do this procedure, but when you're going to do your final pressure, you do. You could just use an air chuck. Nice and tight. Now these, I prefer 120 psi pressure. You can go anywhere from about probably 80, 90 up to about 200, 250. Now as you can see, that shaft's starting to extend. So it's pushed the neck bush all the way up. So you could start screwing that down. All right. Now what you could do, just to be cautious, you could check there's no oil leaks there. Just blow that out. You could leave it 10 minutes, visually check there's no oil. That'd just mean that you may have damaged the seal putting it in. Obviously we won't wait that time because we're doing a video, we'll just put it together. So that screws back down. If you don't have gas pressure in this, you're not going to be able to tighten this up because the whole assembly is going to spin. So it is important to have gas pressure to try and tighten this up. Doesn't need to be super tight, it's only a dust cover. And do your grub screws up. It's two of them. All right, now you can finally check your pressure. Once you've got your pressure done, it is recommended just to put your Schroeder valve cap on, clean the shock down properly, and maybe just leave it for a couple of hours on the bench or overnight. Just check there is no oil leaks anywhere. Just a safety precaution. If you don't have the time to do it, you don't have to do it. Wipe everywhere down, blow everything, that grease and oil out everywhere. You want to make sure you get oil out of here. Oil all around the area, because it'll sit there and you may think you've got an oil leak, but it could just be assembly oil. That's it. For any more information, jump on our website, superiorengineering.com.au, or jump on our YouTube page. Thanks for watching.